Good morning, everyone. I am A. Bhutendra Gaur. I am going to teach you physics class. And another thing, whatever content I am going to deliver, it's strictly confined to CBSE, not more than that. And one more thing, we are going to discuss about chapter 1st, electrostatics of class 12. Right. In class 12, chapter 1 is electrostatics. In that also, we are going to discuss about electric charges and field. To understand electrostatics or various behavior of charges, we have to know what is charge. So we are going to discuss what is charge. Charge is a basic property of a material that has been developed by any material due to which it can attract some tiny particles surrounding it. It can be developed by excess number of electrons or deficient electrons. It can be developed by either by excess electrons or deficient of electron. Based on that, it classified into two types. One is positive charge and another one is negative charge. If we discuss about this naming, there are many scientists who differently named it. Charles named it as vitreous charge and resonance charge, but it is not necessary for CBSE. Whatever we have to remember is that charges of two types, one is positive charge and another one is negative charge, and this property is measurable and it is denoted by capital Q. If it is measurable, it will have some unit, right? Its SI unit is coulomb. In this chapter, we are going to discuss about charge. Charge is a property developed in material due to which it can attract tiny particles around it or it can experience electric and magnetic effects. It is measurable and hence it is denoted by capital Q or small q. Its SI unit is coulomb, CGS unit is stat coulomb or electrostatic unit, and its magnetic unit is electromagnetic unit or ab coulomb. Relation between this SI unit, CGS unit and electromagnetic unit is 1 coulomb is equal to 3 into 10 power 9 stat coulomb. 1 coulomb is equal to 1 by 10 ab coulomb or electromagnetic unit. 1 Faraday is equal to 96,500 coulomb. This is the introduction about charge. Now we know that what is charge. Now another question that will arise in our mind is that how this charge can be developed and what are the factors that develop this charge on a body? What are the factors that develop this charge on a body? Right. Before discussing that, we will discuss about types of charges. First thing is that there are two types of charge. One is positive charge and another one is negative charge. There are many names of this. Different scientists named it differently. But finally, it was decided that types of charge is only based on polarity. And first one is positive charge and another one is negative charge. And the next question that arises in our mind is that how this positive and negative charge can be developed on a body, whether all the bodies possess charge or only charged body possess charge. Generally, each and every body possess charge, whether it is charged or uncharged body. In case of uncharged body, the net charge will be zero, but the amount of positive charge and amount of negative charge is same, just like neutral sodium atom. In this case, the amount of positive charge and amount of negative charge is same. Its atomic number is 11, hence it has 11 electrons which has negative charge and 11 protons which has positive charge, and the total charge will be zero. If a body is uncharged, it doesn't mean that it does not have charge. It has charge but in equal amount. If we want to develop either positive charge or negative charge, we have only to remove this electron, because this electron will decide whether the body will positively charged or negatively charged. This theory is known as electronic theory of charge. In electronic theory of charge, what they told is that if a body has to be positively charged, then there should be deficiency of electron. If it is negatively charged, then there will be excess amount of charge. In another case, we can say that charge is conserved. It can transfer from one body to another body. That we will discuss in properties of charges. At present, you have to remember that positive charge and negative charge will be developed only by the electron. Okay, if charge is deficient, then means number of electrons is deficient or number of negative charges is deficient in a body, then it will be positively charged. If excess number of negative charges are present or excess number of electrons are present, then it will be negatively charged. For example, Na plus ion. In case of Na plus ion, there will be 11 proton of positive charge and 10 electrons of negative charge, and the total charge will be plus E. Here E is basic elementary charge, which is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Now we are going to discuss about properties of charges. There are mainly four properties of charges. First one is additivity of charge. Second one, quantization of charge. Third one, conservation of charge. Fourth one, invariance, charge invariance property. Let us discuss about additivity of charge. Generally, the quantities which are measurable, it can be classified into two types. One is not based on unit, based on values and direction, scalar and vector. Charge is a scalar physical quantity, and hence net charge of any scalar quantity can be obtained by adding all the charges. Now addition can be done in two ways. One is algebraic way and another one is normal sum. Here additivity of charge states that net charge on any body is equal to the algebraic sum of all the charges present on that body. Means algebraic sum means we have to add the values by considering the sign. If we doesn't consider the sign, only we are adding with magnitude, then it is normal sum. For example, it is a irregular body in which different points contain different amount of charge. If different points or different region contains different amount of charge, such type of distribution is said to be discrete charge distribution. Let us consider a irregular body contains different amount of charges at different regions. Like at this point Q1 amount of charge, at this point Q2 amount of charge, at this point Q3, and at this point Q4. If we want total charge on this body, then that net charge is equal to algebraic sum of all these charges. Algebraic sum means I already mentioned that we have to add including the sign. This is the net charge present on that body. This property of charge is said to be additivity of charge. Means in additivity of charge, they are saying that if we want to calculate the total amount of charge on any body, then what we have to do? We have to algebraic do algebraic sum of all the charges present on that body at different regions. This property is additivity of charge, and next property is quantization of charge. The word quantization means integral multiple of some basic quantity. Here also, quantization of charge means the charge on any body will be equal to integral multiple of a basic elementary charge, which is denoted by small e. This e is also known as electronic charge, whose value is e is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. It is said to be electronic charge because it is the minimum charge that present on the electrons. In quantization of charge, they states that charge is equal to integral multiple of basic elementary charge, and the value of this basic elementary charge is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. What is the difference between integer multiple and integral multiple? Integer means only we have to consider the integer value, and integral multiple means if decimal part is also available, we have to take the least value. So Q is equal to Ne is mathematical expression for quantization of charge, and E is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb is basic elementary charge or electronic charge. But there is some drawbacks of quantization of charge. First thing is that quantization of charge fails in modern physics, because in modern physics they have discovered many materials, many minute particles which has fractional part of charges. They are said to be quarks, by which protons, electrons are made. And it also fails in large scale in case of continuous charge distribution. If you, in a body, when continuous charge is distributed, then if we remove small part of charge, the two of value 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb, you can expect this, how much small value is this? If we divide one time with any value, for example, x by 10, what is the value? 0.x, yeah, any number. 1 by 10 means 0.1. 1 by 100 means 0.01. It is 10 power minus 1, it is 10 power minus 2. And now you can expect what is 10 power minus 19. It is 0.00, 17 times 0 and 18 times 0, 16, right? So that much small value. In case of continuous charge distribution, if you remove this part, this amount of charge, it will not affect the total charge of that body. Hence, quantization of charges fails in two cases. One, in continuous charge distribution having large charge. Second one, in case of quarks. In case of quarks, it is integer multiple of charge will be integer multiple. And in case of continuous charge distribution, the amount of charge is very large, such that if you remove few electrons or few electronic charges, it will not affect the total charge of the body. Next property is conservation of charge. Before discussing conservation of charge, let us find how much number of electronic charges has to be added or removed to get body 1 coulomb of charge. Means Q should be 1 coulomb, and we have to find out the value of N. By quantization of charge, Q is equal to Ne. Q is 1, we have to calculate N, and value of E is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. From here, when we calculate the value of N, you will get 6.25 into 10 power 18. Means, if your body has to be negatively charged, we have to give this much excess number of electrons. If we want anybody to get positively charged of 1 coulomb, then we have to remove this much amount of electrons from it. Next, conservation of charge. The word conservation itself defining that what is conservation of charge. Conservation means the material which cannot be created or which we can't destroy. Similarly, conservation of charge means charge can neither be created nor be destroyed. Then we may get question in our mind that how your body is get charged. We already discussed that only by transferring of negative charges. Conservation of charges states that charge is conserved, means neither it can be created nor it can be destroyed. It can transfer from only one body to another body. The body which loses the negative charge get positively charged, and the body which gains the excess negative charge will get negatively charged. And one more thing you have to remember, that transfer of charges includes the transfer of mass. Right, what is invariance? Invariance is the property of charge in which the magnitude of charge does not depend on the frame of reference. In 11th class, we already discussed that there are mainly two frame of reference. One is inertial frame and another one is non-inertial frame. In inertial frame, observer will be at rest or in uniform motion. In non-inertial frame, observer will be in acceleration. In both the cases, wherever we, in which, in both frame of reference, the amount of charge will be same. This property is said to be charge invariance. Now we are going to discuss about methods to charge the body. There are mainly three methods by which we can charge the body. First method is conduction. Second method is induction. Third method is frictional. We can discuss in any order. This is types to charge the body. First one is conduction, second one is induction, and third one is frictional method. First, we are going to discuss about conduction method. Right. In this method, a neutral body can be charged by bringing the neutral body in contact with charged body. Like, for example, consider a body A, which is neutral. If your body is neutral, it means that its charge is zero. And for charging this body, what we have to do? We have to bring this body in contact with another body of charge capital Q. This body may be of same material or different material, but in this chapter, we are strictly restrict this to the same medium. Okay, this body is made up of same material, same shape and same size. In this case, when two bodies are brought in contact with each other, then charge will transfer from higher charged body to lower charged body till equal charges are distributed in both the bodies. Means this body is, this body A of charge 0 is brought in contact with body of charge capital Q. And then we separated it. After separating, we can notice that body A is get charged, and the amount of charge that present on this body is plus Q by 2, and the amount of charge present on B is plus Q by 2. Means what happened here? Charge is transferred from body B to body A till they get equal charges. This method is said to be conduction method. But remember that it is not required that one body should be neutral. Conduction process will also take place when both the bodies are charged. In that case, what happens? Charge will transfer from higher charged body to lower charged body till their charges get equal. For example, if this is the body C of charge small q and this is the body of charge capital Q. We are bringing this body in contact with each other. Small Q and capital Q. Then we are separating it. After separating it, they will get equally charged. Equally charged, how we will get that equal charge? By adding these charges and divided by number of bodies in contact. Small Q plus capital Q by small q plus capital Q by 2. This method is known as conduction. And remember that in this chapter we are discussing when bodies are made up of same medium and same size and same material, then only this principle will be applicable. Otherwise we have to consider the potential, that we will discuss in next chapter. At present we have to know this only, when two similar bodies means same shape and same material are of different charges are brought in contact with each other, it charge will get transferred from higher charged body to lower charged body till the charges become same. In this process we can notice that the polarity of charge is same till the last. Initially we get positively charged body which we brought in contact with neutral body, and finally we will get positively charged body only. If negatively charged body is brought in contact with neutral body, then both the bodies will get negatively charged. Second method, induction. For discussing induction, we have to know what is earthing. Earthing is a process in which a material is connected to the ground by a conducting wire. What happens if we connect a body through a conducting wire to the earth? Charge will get transferred. How? For example, it is a body having positively charged. If it is get earthed means by using a conducting wire we have to ground it to the earth. Okay, this is the symbol of earthing. Here what happens, electron will transfer from earth to the body, and always remember that the potential of earth is considered as zero, means it is always considered as neutral body. How much charge we may given or we taken from the earth, because its size is huge compared to the bodies present on the earth. So charge will travel from earth to body till this body gets neutralized. If we connect the body to the earth by using conducting wire and the body is positively charged, if this body is negatively charged, in this case negative charge will move to earth till this body get neutralized. This will happen when we connect any body to the earth. By using this process and inducing process, we can develop charge on a body. How it can happen? Consider a neutral body and we are bringing a charged body closer to this body. It is a glass rod of positively charged. By other means we have charged this glass rod and we brought this glass rod close to this body which is placed on the insulating stand. When we brought this glass rod closer to body A, we can notice that the same polarity charge will reside at far end of the body and opposite polarity charge will reside at close end of the body. The amount of charge that resides at close end of the body, Q dash, is equal to charge of the glass rod. It is opposite polarity, that's why minus is used. Charge of the glass rod 1 minus 1 by K, where K is dielectric constant of the body A. So when a glass rod brought closer to the body, what happens here, due to this positive charge, negative charge will get attracted to near end of the body and positive charge will reside at far end of the body. Now what we are going to do, at far end we are going to earth it. when we earth, we already discussed that if positive charged body is connected to the earth, negative charge will travel from earth to body till the charges get neutralized. After neutralization of positive charge, we have to cancel the earthing, means we have to cut the earthing, and only negative charge present on this body. You may ask that why negative charge doesn't travel to the body. The reason is that it is holded by this positively charged rod. Now, by removing this positively charged rod, this negative charge will equally distributed throughout the body, and this method is known as charging by induction. In induction method, what we done, we induced the charge by using the glass rod, and the amount of charge developed on this body is equal to this, means the negative charge what is in whatever induced here is only present on this body, that's why this values will be same. Third is frictional method. Now we are going to discuss about frictional method. In this method, when a body is rubbed with another body, the body will get equally charged but of opposite polarity. For example, when a glass rod is rubbed with silk cloth, what happens here, some amount of negative charge will transfer from glass rod to the silk cloth, and we already discussed that when electron is lost by anybody, it will get positively charged, and when electron is gained by anybody, it will get negatively charged. Here the amount of charge will be same in both the bodies but of different polarity. One will be positive polarity and another will be negative polarity. Remember that in frictional method or any type of method, mass transfer takes place because charge developed due to transfer of electron. Here electron will possess some amount of mass because mass of electron on the body is on an electron is equal to 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. If one electron is transferred from one body to another body, this is much amount of mass is transferred from one body to another body. And another thing that we have to notice, example of glass silk is already discussed. Another example is when ebonite rod is rubbed with fur, ebonite get negatively charged and fur get positively charged. When amber is rubbed with wool, amber get negatively charged, wool get positively charged. When comb is rubbed with hair, comb get negatively charged and hair get positively charged. And this experiment can be done in home also. When we rub comb with our hair and we bring closer to tiny papers, we can notice that comb attracts those tiny papers because comb get charged or electrified. Okay, sir.